Well, for every Israeli or American hostage executed by Hamas, we should take down an Iranian oil refinery. The only way you're gonna keep this war from escalating is to hold Iran accountable.
So that was Senator Lindsey Graham getting a little too worked up about the idea of the United States entering into a conflict with Iran. Now, of course, Graham is notorious for being a war hawk. He was making those comments in response to Hamas, which has pledged to start executing their hostages. So a little bit more on that from NBC News. A spokesperson for the military wing of Hamas has said militants will kill one civilian hostage every time Israel targets civilians in their home in Gaza without warning. Abu Obeida, spokesman of the Qassam Brigade, said the executions would be broadcast in audio and video. So of course it goes without saying that killing hostages is vile. So right now I'd just like to take this opportunity to plea to the Israeli government, who has all the power in this situation, who holds all the cards, to stop killing innocent Palestinian civilians, to come to the table and call generally for peace, because this is preventable. This violence is preventable. Innocent civilians don't have to die. And it's Israel's responsibility to make that decision. But back to Lindsey Graham, his idea for retaliation, which you're about to hear the rest of, is a massive escalation, of course, and jumps to a conclusion about Iran's involvement in the war. Take a look.
How much more death and destruction do we have to take from the Iranian regime? I am confident this was planned and funded by the Iranians. Hamas is a bunch of animals who deserve to be treated like animals. So if I was Israel, I would go in on the ground. There is no truce to be had here. I would dismantle Hamas. This is the best opportunity Israel has to destroy Hamas. Take it to the Iranians. If you harm one American in Syria by using your Iranian militia against us in Syria, if you escalate the war by urging Hezbollah to attack Israel in the north, if Hamas kills one American and Israeli hostage, we're gonna blow up your oil refineries and put you out of business. It is now time to take the war to the Ayatollah's backyard.
So this is particularly insane because we don't know the full extent, if any, of Iran's involvement in these attacks. Now, Secretary of State Antony Blinken said this on NBC News. "We don't have anything that shows us that Iran was directly involved in this attack, in planning it or carrying out, but that's something we're looking at very carefully and we've got to see where the facts lead." So Secretary of State Antony Blinken says they have no evidence whatsoever that Iran was involved. That didn't stop Lindsey Graham for calling for war with Iran. However, I do want to point out that that is contrary to this report from the Wall Street Journal that was published yesterday that says this: Iranian security officials helped plan Hamas's Saturday surprise attack on Israel and gave the green light for the assault and a meeting in Beirut last Monday, according to senior members of Hamas and Hezbollah, another Iran-backed militant group. Continues on, the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps' broader plan is to create a multi-front threat that can strangle Israel from all sides. Hezbollah and the Popular Front for the Liberation of Palestine in the north, and Palestinian Islamic Jihad and Hamas in Gaza and the West Bank, according to the senior Hamas and Hezbollah members and an Iranian official. So that is the one report that does make a connection, runs contrary to what the Secretary of State Antony Blinken has said. But you know, Cenk, one thing I've been seeing a lot is people saying that what happened this weekend is Israel's 9/11, and I see truth in that, people are using it as an excuse to call for brutal war, as well as spread rabid Islamophobia. I've seen increases in that across social media. But I mean, that is exactly what Lindsey Graham is doing, right? Capitalizing on this as an opportunity to execute the war that he's been pushing for quite some time now.
Yeah, so I'm gonna get to Lindsey Graham in 1 second, but look, we urge restraint on the part of the Israeli government. I also wish that Hamas had been restrained before they did this stupid, immoral act that is totally counterproductive to their Palestinian cause, the Palestinian people, let alone what they did to innocent Israeli civilians. Having said that, yes, please, Israel, show some degree of way more decency than Hamas showed in how you deal with the civilians. And if the idea is this talk of calling people animals is disgusting. And so the defense minister of Israel said that these are human animals and that they're gonna treat them that way. And there's gonna be a purge and a siege. They're gonna cut off food, water, electricity to all of Gaza. Well, all of Gaza didn't do it. All of Israel didn't say yes to the occupation. There's left-wing Israelis, centrist Israelis. Collective punishment is a war crime for good reason. It never makes sense. It's the wrong way to go. Does it require you to have more restraint than your enemies? Yes. Aren't you supposed to be better than your enemies? So I know that asking for restraint in a time when Israelis are enraged is a tough thing to ask, but nevertheless we ask it because the violence has to stop at some point. Not to say that there shouldn't be any retaliation against Hamas, but for God's sake, collective punishment of the Palestinian people is not the right answer going forward. All right, now to Lindsey Graham. Look, this monster is in favor of war and more war at all times, and so in all situations. Iran is four times the size of Iraq. If we start bombing Iran, as Lindsey Graham is suggesting now, yes, his donors would be greatly enriched, and Lindsey Graham, that corrupt piece of crap, would also be greatly enriched by his donors, the oil companies. They would love it if we had a war, because the price of gas would go through the roof. It could get to $10. They would make trillions of dollars in extra profit, and they would share a small piece of that with a corrupt, indecent Lindsey Graham, who would probably celebrate the death of all of those innocent civilians in Iran and Israel and Palestine and all the different places that this would affect, as long as his donors got richer. He's a disgusting human being who's always advocated for more blood, more violence, and more war. Also, the defense contractors, also giant donors to Lindsey Graham, would be beside themselves with joy as they provided missile after missile for the death of so many civilians. The answer is not more war, the answer is more peace. I know our leaders never give you that option, but for God's sake, we all, Americans, Israelis, Palestinians, we all have to elect leaders that are for more peace and not more war. Lindsey Graham is one of the most disgusting people I have seen in American politics. He led the death of hundreds of thousands of innocent Iraqi civilians, and now he's saying we should do that on an even grander scale in Iran. No, we should not bomb Iran. No, we should not start a giant war in the Middle East that will definitely harm the innocent civilians of all those countries, including Israel, including America. And then, by the way, after he starts that war, he's gonna wanna send your kids to go fight that war. And your answer to that should be hell no.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.